My name is Eldad Cohen. I'm the author of the novel Ima Kumi, in English, Wake Up Mom. This is a story of a child who lives with his mother in Machane Yehuda in Jerusalem, in a small 2.5-room flat overlooking the market stalls. And it so happened that he is going for treatment to his father, who is a psychologist, with the father not knowing that he is treating his son, and without his mother knowing he's going for treatment at all. When the father tells him he can't treat children without the presence of the parents, Yehuda recruits Captain Abbott, his best mate in the market, to act as his father in the session with his father. Captain Abbott is an ex-soldier who fought in 1973 traumatic war and is suffering from PTSD. He is one of the large gallery of colorful characters who inhabit the novel and Yehuda's journey between his mother and father. The novel taking place mostly in Jerusalem in the early 1980s and is told from Yehuda's point of view. He's a sensitive, clever child with lots of obsessive-compulsive habits that rule his life.
If there's a hole in one leg of my pants, I cut a hole in the other leg. If the hole I cut bigger than the first hole, I go back and make the first hole a little bigger so it will be the same size as the hole I cut in the second leg of my pants. If the first hole is bigger than the hole in the second leg of my pants, I make the second hole bigger so it will be the same size as the hole in the first leg of my pants. Sometimes this happens on the way to school, when I'm sitting in the back seat because my mom won't let me sit in the front seat at least until my bar mitzvah. We drive to school, and I'm busy with my pants the whole time. Sometimes when I get to school, my pants are completely torn apart. You're not allowed to walk around school in your underwear. That's a rule everyone has to obey. Even the principal isn't allowed to walk around in his underwear. So my mom has to make a U-turn and drive back to the Machne Yehuda market where we live, because there's no place to buy pants near the school, even though such a big neighborhood deserves to have a store that sells pants.
It's, if I try to find a way to define it, a sort of urban fairy tale, a circus of the mind, and a growing up tale. In the course of the story, Yehuda experiences for the first time some of the great things in life, among them love and death. Thank you very much.